So Microsoft recently announced their new Surface Go. It's this 2-in-1 device, starts at $400, and I think it's the cheapest or one of the cheapest computing devices that Microsoft has ever put out. And it's actually, in my opinion, one of the most interesting devices that they've put out in quite a while. This isn't it. This is a Surface Pro 4. Very similar in idea and design though. So what makes this thing special though is the price tag. $400 is very affordable, and I think a lot of people are looking at it out of interest, as am I. So I just took a look at their launch video and I just had a couple thoughts on the device as a whole. The first thing I noted is that the CPU, you can only get in one configuration. It's the 4415Y Pentium Gold, came out middle of last year or something like that. Not a super new chip, but it's relatively power efficient and has very respectable performance for a fanless chip. It's noticeably faster than some of the older Surface devices, but its main strength is the onboard GPU. That HD615 is quite a big step up from older devices. Now, if you look at the price point of $400, it's quite attractive there, but I feel like that's a bit of a marketing ploy because that $400 version, as cool as it sounds, is, I don't think it's the one to get. If you're gonna look at this, I would look at the kind of mid-tier model, the $550 version. Here's why. That $400 version has 4 gigs of RAM. That's not like a deal breaker to me. 4 gigs is not great, but it's not the end of the world. It's the drive speed. So they're using eMMC storage in the base model, and that is really, really slow stuff. If you step up to the mid-tier model, they're using NVMe storage, and that faster storage has a huge, huge role in just how the device feels overall. So if you're interested in this thing, I would highly recommend the 8 gig model. Not, again, it's not about the RAM, it's the storage speed. It's just NVMe is so much faster, that's the one to get. The bezels on this device are a little thick, but since it's a tablet, I'm less bothered by it. Like when you have a thicker bezel to hold on to, it's just, I don't know, kind of serves as like a grip so you don't have accidental swipes and touches like that. The kickstand on the Surface Go goes all the way back, like the 2017 Surface Pro, so 165 degrees, I think. That type of functionality on a kickstand honestly makes this device so much more versatile to me. It obviously depends on the user, but if you're using it for like drawing or like writing or anything like that, that kickstand that folds all the way back is money. As for ports on the Surface Go, you're getting a USB-C port this time, which is really nice. You can charge with it, you can connect stuff to it, display out, all that good stuff. It's your standard USB-C. It doesn't support Thunderbolt 3, not surprising given what the product is. I don't even think it would have been all that useful considering the CPU. Like, what are you gonna do with that Thunderbolt 3 port? Now, the included charger still uses the Surface Connect port. It's not a USB-C charger, but it's still nice that it does support USB-C charging. The type cover goes for $100. I think most users will want to pick this up with the device. They've made the touchpad bigger. Nice to see that. I've always found the touch covers to be kind of annoying that it comes as a separate thing. Like on some of these devices, especially on the base model, a type cover is going to be 20% the cost of your whole device. Like that's crazy. $100 of a $500 kit is like, that's very expensive for a keyboard, but it is what it is. Surface likes to do that. Now I took a look at some older models just to see what was out there, to see if there was other stuff that you get instead of the Surface Go, just to, I don't know, just kind of like a comparison of competitors and alternatives. And I actually think that the Surface Go is a very, it's kind of in a class of its own. If you get anything that's older, like yeah, you're gonna get similar processing power and sometimes larger screens and maybe some better functionality, but the overall product of the Surface Go has a lot of features that are unique to it that just make it a very respectable and reasonable purchase, like the USB-C charging, the Windows Hello, the updated screen with good pen support. It looks like a really cool device. The unfortunate thing is that instead of that $400 price point that Microsoft is touting, it looks like it's gonna be like $650 to get a really kind of fully functional kit going for like the mid-tier model and a keyboard. So it's not super cheap, but I think it's respectable. I don't know, what do you guys think? Like, is this something that you're interested in? Because this can't be, or this, it's unlikely that most people can use this as their primary device. Certainly not for like the people that watch my channel. You guys are enthusiasts, you care about tech, and you usually have something that's a little more powerful than this, but it's good as a secondary device, I think. And I think for me personally, if I wasn't making YouTube videos, I would actually try to pick up one of these things as my primary device just to see how far I could get on it. It's pretty cool. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.